Welcome aboard. The first part of the video shows a perfectly executed scoop by my co-pilot on the northern coast of Galicia, filmed from outside the aircraft. The speed is above 80 knots, but below 90. The nose landing gear doors remain clear of the water. The tail does not strike the waves, and only the probes designed for this purpose make contact with the surface, absorbing the impact in the direction of flight. At this speed, and with the correct angle of attack, the pilot has sufficient aerodynamic control to neutralize the pitching movement generated when the probes touch the water. In fact, the pilot never stops actively flying the aircraft. This is not a simple touch and go at your local airport. This is precision flying at its finest. The second part of the video shows another well-executed scoop, again by my young co-pilot, during his first fire season, but this time on the western coast of Galicia and filmed from the cockpit. The maneuver is smooth, even relaxed, and the correct nose position is confirmed by the absence of the stall warning alert. While scooping, a stall warning indicates an excessive angle of attack and therefore an abnormal nose high position. At sea, the scooping speed must be around 85 knots. This ensures the pilot maintains full control of the aircraft at all times. By contrast, with incorrect technique, nose high and low speed, the tail constantly strikes the waves, and the pilot cannot always prevent the aircraft from pitching down, the nose from dropping, and the landing gear doors from hitting the water, thereby endangering the aircraft's structural integrity. When I left my squadron in the spring of 2019, I was asked to write a brief document outlining the correct procedure for scooping at sea, specifically the technique that some of us instructors had been teaching new generations over the previous decade. At that time, I was 40 years old and had been flying the Super Scooper for 18 fire seasons. I was an aircraft captain, test pilot and instructor pilot, and had logged no fewer than 9,000 water scoops and more than 3,000 flight hours on the type. There has always been little official literature on the subject. In fact, the aircraft's AFM stated only two things. Scooping should be performed at the highest possible speed and the tail should not strike the water. Old school pilots tended to scoop at sea with the nose excessively high. My squadron had experienced several accidents caused by the nose landing gear doors hitting the water, and understandably, there was a generalized, poorly managed fear of the sea among the crews. However, regardless of their good intentions, that approach violated the manufacturer's instructions and was dangerous for both crew and aircraft. The belief that keeping the nose abnormally high would prevent the gear doors from touching the water was unfounded. Unfortunately, it wasn't until 2012, when we began installing external cameras on the aircraft, that we were able to prove this. Maintaining an excessively nose-high attitude while scooping causes the tail to strike the surface, which over time leads to fatigue cracks in the tail section. Furthermore, to maintain such a position, speed must be reduced, otherwise the aircraft will simply lift off. At this reduced speed, the pilot lacks sufficient aerodynamic control to maneuver the aircraft effectively during the water scoop, risking loss of control in one of the most critical maneuvers in aviation. That said, I fully agree that the nose landing gear doors must never touch the water. They're not designed to withstand high-speed contact, and their failure could compromise the aircraft's whole integrity. I believe this video clearly demonstrates that, with the correct technique, the doors remain clear of the water and the tail avoids contact with the waves. The procedure is the same whether scooping in closed waters or in open sea. This technique demands concentration and solid stick and rudder skills, but with proper training, my experience shows that any Super Scooper pilot can perform it safely and effectively.